you prove the existence of the external world?
I can now give a perfectly rigorous proof. I can prove now, for instance, that two human hands exist. How? By holding up my two hands, and saying, as I make a certain gesture with the right hand, here is one hand, and adding, as I make a certain gesture with the left, and here is another.
Why do you call that a perfectly rigorous proof?
The proof which I gave was a perfectly rigorous one, and it is perhaps impossible to give a better or more rigorous proof of anything whatever.
That's absurd. I can give a more rigorous proof that 1 plus 1 equals 2. But, anyway, why do you think your proof is perfectly rigorous?
Number 1, the premise which I adduced as proof of the conclusion was different from the conclusion I adduced it to prove.
So be it.
Number 2, the premise which I adduced was something which I knew to be the case, and not merely something which I believed but which was by no means certain, or something which, though in fact true, I did not know to be so.
Let's come back to this.
And number 3, the conclusion did really follow from the premise.
Your first and third conditions are true, but your second condition is rubbish.
No way. My premise is here is one hand and here is another. I know that this premise is true. It's not a belief that lacks certainty.
But isn't it circular? Your premise presupposes that there's an external world. Therefore your conclusion is implicitly presupposed by your premise.
I don't think it's fair to say that my premise presupposes the truth of my conclusion. For I'm not using the truth of my conclusion as a reason to believe my premise. The evidence for my premise is right before me. It's that I see my hands.
That's just your interpretation of the real evidence.
What do you mean? What's the real evidence?
The real evidence is that you're having a hand-like visual experience. Your interpretation is that you're seeing hands. You're ignoring or dismissing alternative interpretations, such as that you're dreaming of hands, or hallucinating hands.
I know that I'm not dreaming or hallucinating. Yet, although I know it, I cannot prove it.
How do you know it?
I just do, all right.